Welcome to the next session of oscillators. So in this session we are going to discuss about LC tuned circuits. Now the basic configuration of a LC tuned circuit consists of an amplifier circuit, and we have the reactive elements connected in a particular pattern. So here X1, X2 and X3, they form the reactance elements. Okay, so this is the basic configuration. Okay, now there are two commonly used configurations of these LC tuned circuits. So now based on X1, X2 and X3 values. Okay, so if X1 is also capacitance and X2 is also capacitance, but X3 is equal to inductance L, so this configuration is known as Colpitts oscillator configuration. But if X1 is equal to inductance, X2 is also equal to inductance, but if X3 is equal to capacitance, so this is known as Hartley oscillator configuration. Okay, so now both of these configurations, Colpitts and Hartley, they utilize parallel LC circuits, which is also known as a tank circuit, which is connected between collector and the base in case of BJT circuits. So the next slide shows the configurations of Colpitts circuit and Hartley circuit in case of BJT circuits. So figure A, this is the Colpitts circuits, and in figure B we have Hartley circuit. Now in these two circuits, the biasing circuit is not included. Okay, it is just a connection to highlight the connection of the tank circuits, that's all. Okay, so therefore the biasing elements are excluded in this. Now whatever the resistance R is there, so this is going to model the combination of losses of inductors as well as load resistance of the oscillator and output resistance of the transistors. Okay, so the frequency of oscillation in these oscillators, so this will be determined by the resonance frequency of the tank circuit, and where this tank circuit acts like a reservoir for energy storage. So now in case of Colpitts oscillator, okay, the frequency of oscillation is given by omega naught equal to 1 by square root of L into C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. And similarly in case of Hartley oscillator, the frequency of oscillation will be given by 1 by square root of L1 plus L2 into C. Okay, so here the ratios L1 by L2 or the C1 by C2, so they will determine the feedback factors. Okay, so now a practical LC circuit, that is Colpitts oscillator, is taken as example, is as shown here in the figure. Now this is a complete Colpitts oscillator because it includes all the biasing arrangement also. So in this circuit, inductor L, C1 and C2 form the tank circuit, and the biasing and stabilization is given by the resistors RB1, RB2 as well as the emitter resistor RE here. And also here the RFC choke, it provides a high reactance at the frequencies omega naught, but a low DC resistance, and here a capacitor CE which is connected across RE, it acts as short circuit at the high frequencies so that the output is completely fed back to the input terminals through the coupling capacitor CC in correct phase. Okay, so this is the CE and this we can represent as a coupling capacitor CC. Okay, so therefore here in this case the frequency of oscillation is given by f is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC, where C is C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. Okay, so this is a Colpitts circuit using BJT, so with complete biasing arrangement. Now we have another oscillator circuit called as a clap oscillator, as shown in this circuit diagram. See, in the previous Colpitts oscillator, okay, so the frequency of oscillations, so whatever equations we have written here, frequency of oscillations F, it completely depends on the capacitors C1 and C2. Okay, but these two capacitors C1 and C2, they are shunted by the stray capacitance in the transistors. So because of these capacitances, the output frequency will not be same as the designed frequency value. So this is a demerit, and in order to overcome this drawback of this Colpitts oscillator, now a little modification is done in the tank circuit. So here the inductor L is replaced by the series combination of capacitor C3 and the inductor L. So the value of C3 is taken as very small when compared to C1 C2 values. So that is here C3 is very much less than C1 and C2 values. Okay, now with this modification in the tank circuit, the advantage here is the stability of the circuit is improved because now the frequency of oscillation is made to depend only on the capacitor C3 and not on either C1 or C2 or any other stray capacitances. Okay, so this modified Colpitts oscillator is known as the clap oscillator, as shown in this figure. Okay, so remaining every biasing arrangement is just similar to the Colpitts arrangement only. So now in case of this clap oscillator, okay, we can derive the frequency of oscillation as omega naught equal to 1 by root LC, where this 1 by LC is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Okay, but as C3 is very much less than C1 C2, so C is approximately taken as C3 only. By considering that, omega naught will be equal to simply root L C3. Okay, so therefore the frequency of oscillation F naught will be 1 by 2 pi root L C3. So this is a frequency of oscillation in case of complete clap oscillator.